final four.
Okay.
Two head to head.
Okay.
Final.
Depending on your sign up.
Your winner. Yeah.
Okay. No, it's still unbelievable. Think about it. Really good. And there'll be someone down there tapping them, right? Stephanie said that.
Well, you and I can go. You and Stephanie will be doing that. You know, you will.
Okay.
But you can walk here and go there.
Oh, that's okay. Okay.
But that's when
he's got what wireless. That's correct.
With it.
Wireless. He has it right now.
Awesome.
Okay, awesome.
I don't know why they're wrong.
Watch out.
Welcome to Atlanta Sightseeing. Please take your seat and keep your hands and feet inside the railing at all times. Welcome to Atlanta Sightseeing. Please take your seat and keep your hands and feet inside the railing at all times.
Ma'am, in this brochure it says this tour is crunk. What does that mean?
Hammers and bones, back to the machinist. The clothes, adolescents packing up. A knock on the door.
Who is it?
Don't happen to know the one with the flow.
Who did it?
It was me, I suppose. Jay-Z in the rolls and looters in the cut supreme. Skating down on neck, tucked and lean. Just plain, as a matter of fact, I'm 15. No blood on the sneaks, gotta keep it so my kitchen's clean. I get the cream, cop see me flick my beans. I'm allergic to Doc McBride and a histamine. Oink, oink, pig, pig, do away with the pork. Only silver I need is a steak knife and a fork. I'm Bruce with banners, ludicrous, shiny rockets when I the cannon. The woolly mammoth saber tooth, bite your tongue. I won't stop until I'm rich as the whites will come. I pull up in a black lotus, your blacks are bogus. So I strip them off the wall, waiting for my cue to corner pocket eight ball. You racking them up on big paper like pancakes, stacking them up. In fact, I'm slapping them up. Cadillac is a truck, I can't lose with 22. That's what's up. Running in the back of better than the aqua duck.
Things like every day, big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming, and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta, where the players play, and we ride on them things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming, and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Yeah, the party don't start till I walk in, and I usually don't leave until the thing ends, but in the meantime, in between time, you work your thing, I work mine. I've been putting down here since 83, since the Lake Show MD rivalry. When throw the bad ice with the place to be. If you was riding, you was bumping the homie Shy D. I'm the MVP, most ballin' player. Make my own rules, call me the mayor. Monday night, gentlemen's club. Tuesday night, I'm up in the velvet room, getting Wednesday, I'm at Strokers on lean. Thursday, jump clean, then I fall up in cream. Friday, sharp bar Kyle with Frank Ski. Right on the flow is where you can find me. Saturday, is off the heezy for sheezy. You can find me up in one tweezy. Sunday, is when I get my sleep in. Cause on Monday, we be at it again. Holla, yeah, 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 yeah. And we ride on things like every day. Big beats hit streets, see gangsters roaming, and parties don't stop till 8 in the morning.
Welcome to Atlanta where the play is play, and we ride on them things like every day. Better than this.
I think this would work.
Try it.
I don't want to. Would this be picked up?
Let's see it. Let's see it. Let's turn it on.
Check. Test.
Is this on? Did you keep it on?
I turn it off because it has a lot of feedback. I just put.
Just, okay, I'll wait then.
Okay,
just put it.
Check.
Yeah, that's all right. 21-0 Clemson.
Yeah.
And that was like 15 minutes ago, so it's probably worse. I just don't get it.
Bring them out. It's hard to yell when the barrel's in your mouth.
Come on.
Bring them out. Albuquerque to check time. Got the crowd yelling, bring them out.
Welcome to Atlanta Sightseeing. Please take your seat and keep your hands and feet inside the railing at all times.
Ma'am, in this brochure it says this tour is crunk. What does that mean?
And we welcome you inside the Georgia Rush Sports Complex for this NISA match involving Miami FC and the Atlanta Soccer Club. Your officials for tonight's contest is Kyle Johnston, Jordan Morris, Christopher Hagerty, and Jared Mosher. Now to the team's starting lineups. First for the visitors, for Miami FC, the goalkeeper, number one, Mark Pace. The defenders, number 45, Jalen Markey. Number 2, Othello Ba. Number 4, Mateus Silva. And number 11, Lloyd Sam. The midfielders, number 8, Tomas Granito. Number 16, Harrison Heath. Number 17, Brian James. And the forwards, Mohamed Chow. Number 12, Miguel Gonzalez. And the captain, number 6, Dylan Maris. Miami FC is coached by Paul Dalglish. Now, fans, let's get on our feet for your Atlanta FC. In goal, the captain, that's number 1, Jordan Bell. The defenders, number 3, Manu Moreno. Number 21, Mohamed Lamine. Number 42, David Coloco. And number five, the big fella, Ramsey Touré Idrisu. In the midfield, let's give a warm welcome to number 14. That's Jeffrey O'Too. The man of the match from last Sunday, number 8, Alex Frank. And the Atlanta SC leading goal scorer, number 7, Nazim Bartman. Your forwards, number 10, the Prince Sadie. Number 9, William Eyang. And number 11, that's Molly Carpe Jr. Atlanta's coached by Roberto Neves. Fans, please rise and take off your hats as we play the national anthem. And a warm Saturday afternoon welcome here at the Georgia Rush. At the Georgia Rush Sports Complex for this NISA League match involving Miami FC and the Atlanta Soccer Club. You just saw the starting lineups. Mark Pace in goal for Miami. The back line of Marky, Ba, Silva, and Sam. In the midfield, Granito, Heath, and James. And then up front, Mohamed Chow had that brace on Sunday. Miguel Gonzalez, who can certainly score goals. And the great Dylan Maris, the captain here for Miami, who is two goals away from the Miami FC franchise record. No Ariel Martinez in the starting lineup. A lot of changes here from last Sunday. Brenton Griffiths, the steady backline presence, not here as well. Meanwhile, for Atlanta SC, well, it's business as usual. It's the same starting 11 as we saw just 5 days ago. Jordan Bell, the captain in goal. The back line of Marino, Lamine, Coloco, and Ramsey, Torre, Idrisu. Then the midfield, former Atlanta United product Jeffrey O'Too, the man of the match, and Alex Frank, who is phenomenal on Sunday. And Nazim Bartman, with his two goals leading the way, will be that attacking midfielder. Up front, Prince AD, the electric lightning Prince AD, William Eyang, and Molly Carpa Jr. The officials tonight, Kyle Johnston is the referee, Jordan Morris, AR1, Christopher Haggerty, AR2, and Jared Mosher is the fourth official. And good evening as we welcome you here into Alpharetta, Georgia. I am Justin Hanover. We'll have the thoughts later on from Miami FC's Kartik Krishnayar, who will join us at some point throughout the broadcast. You'll see Miami in their orange and blue, the back-to-back NPSL champions, the winners of 8 trophies in the past 3 seasons. Miami FC certainly the gold standard here in early NISA League play. Meanwhile, Atlanta SC, nobody knew what to expect of Roberto Neves' team. Well, they were really, really good on Sunday. Scoring in that second minute of added time was Alex Frank for the 2-2 draw. If Atlanta can get a win here, they will only need a point in 2 weeks in Stumptown to get to that championship final in the East and have another rematch with Miami FC. Meanwhile, Paul Dalglish's squad has punched their ticket into that East championship. Don't know yet if they'll be first or second, depending upon this match. But they will certainly be in the final, as they're accustomed to, winners of 27 of their last 29 contests, unbeaten in their last 17. It was 16 straight wins before they tangled last Sunday. So about to get underway, Miami FC moving right to left. Maris on the ball. You'll see Chow, number 9 in there. Actually, Dylan Maris, pardon me, number 6, closer. So that is not Dylan on the ball. And you'll see Othello Ba, who is ticketed to play in the back up here, number 2, on this near side. Referee Kyle Johnston blows the whistle, and we are underway here. Frank with the intercept. Bartman looks to play it to the speed of Carpa Jr., and that'll go out of bounds for Othello Ba. Once again, we're at the home of Georgia Rush at the Georgia Rush Soccer Complex here, a beautiful five-field facility. Flowing pitches, ready-made for any style of a match. There's Harrison Heath, the former Atlanta United player. Manu Marino misses. Now on that left side, which Atlanta certainly can exploit. They did it a bunch on Sunday with Prince Sadie and his speed. They were working a lot on that in training. As you know, Sadie's going to get a run or two free down that left side, and it's just a matter of being able to finish on either him or the cross into the box. And Jordan Bell will get his first touch. The Scottish keeper, 27 years old. As he plays long, very big foot. Bartman trying to track it down, and he's going to make pace come out and have to play that with his feet. Nazim a little bit banged up in training. Looks to be all right, though, here. Lamine was on Atlanta SC last season. Came in right around the time Ricardo George did as well. Ricardo on the bench for tonight's match, eligible to come in. Alex Frank with the head ball. That's played over. And I think that's Molly Carpa that's on the ground, and it is. Molly holding on to that left knee. And Harold King, the legendary trainer of Atlanta SC, is looking on. We'll see if he comes out. Looks like Molly's all right. Tons of speed on each flank for Atlanta with Carpa and Sadie. Something that the head coach of Miami, Paul Dalglish, raved about to Carter Krishnayer in an interview a couple of days ago, just talking about the speed on this Atlanta Soccer Club squad. You can't teach speed. And you see some of it right there with the big fellow, Willie Meyang, who played in Central Florida in NPSL action, played against Miami. Some room here on this left side now. Looking to attack on the right. There's Heath, looks to play it through. Well back by Sadie as he looks to run. Can they find Princeton? Not given the advantage by Kyle Johnston. Atlanta will have to pull that one back and start anew. David Coloco had that big long pass down to Iyang, which led to the first goal off that set piece, which Bartman was able to put in. Ooh, hopping ball and played away by Ramsey Torrey. Ramsey was on the Philadelphia Fury. And then when everything that went down there, with his solid play, little phone call, and suddenly Torre Adrisu in the mix here in Atlanta. Played in that 8-1 Miami victory over Philadelphia about a month ago on match day one. Here comes Lamine with a good win. Plays defeat. Ian gets dispossessed by Heath, who played very well last Sunday, did Harrison Heath, the son of Adrian Heath. Coach has been around for a while. Ball bouncing a bit. Here's Chow in the area, and very well played to avert any trouble, as Muhammad Chow certainly knows how to finish. We know that well. Alex Frank looking to win it. Cannot. Bartman comes back. This is a natural grass surface. Ball can bounce occasionally. Little unorthodox. And that's knocked out of harm's way. Knocked out of everything's way by Mateus Silva, the 22-year-old from Sao Paulo. Started that last match. Miami with a little bit of a leaky back line in that last match, and now they're without Brenton Griffiths, who is pretty much the anchor, the mainstay back there. So it'll be interesting to see these first few minutes how the Orange and Blue are able to react without Griffiths and with guys that necessarily haven't been around for the long haul. Foul called as Nazim Bartman takes a shot and a set piece upcoming about 30 or so yards out. Atlanta very effective in those set pieces on Sunday. Scored the goal as Jeffrey Otoo. Otoo about 7 yards closer, I'd say, than this distance. Alex Frank ran near post. He hit it off the post, and Bartman able to one-time it in with that left foot. And then from the other side, the header by Alex Frank went off the crossbar and post. So here's the South African Bartman. Or pardon me, that's Jeffrey Otoo. Bartman in right around the circle area. Here is Jeffrey. Oh, hand goes up. I guess that hit off a head. And Miami looking to counter. Otoo able to come onto it on that strong left foot. Not cleared out well enough. Onto William Iang's foot. Sadie now looking to go 1v1. Gets that quick first step. Plays it across. Oh, and Pace just gets a paw on it. Now played in the area. Lamine skies that one. And Miami looks to be out of danger as they go the other way. Here is Lamine. Too heavy of a touch. And Miguel Gonzalez, you see number 12, can score a ton of goals. Ken Gonzalez, a 29-year-old from the state of Washington, played with the switchbacks in USL play over in Colorado. Long ball played in. Second ball upcoming. Atlanta works on this a lot. And Jeffrey Otoo with a really good job to win that over to Molly Karpa. Atlanta looking strong once again here in the first few minutes. Certainly not afraid of Miami. There's no fear. The visitors had that 16-game winning streak. As I mentioned, that was stopped on Sunday. Atlanta looking to go one more pedal. One more step up the rung of this ladder. Miami plays it across. Here's Silva. Had that mistake in the last game. Led to an Iang one-on-one on Bryant Martin. But Martin was up to the task on that one. Heath now goes with the long left foot. As you see Prince AD all over the pitch coming back to defend. Oh, that's a good ball played up. Bounces, though, too high to really get much of a dangerous factor on it. And Ramsey Torre gets it over to Alex Frank. Little 1-2. Oh, clever stuff. Just ran out of real estate on that far side. 0-0 here in Alpharetta, Georgia. Miami FC and Atlanta SC. Appreciate A-Plus, one of our sponsors here, one of the most professional, best training facilities around. It's a new age facility, about a year old now. President and General Manager Fode Dalla owning that as well. Just about 10 or 12 minutes here from the sports complex. You want to train a son? You want to train yourself? Manu Moreno, some of the other professionals are out there helping to train some of the young kids as well as the adults. A-Plus Sports in Alpharetta, check it out. Harrison Heath plays it in. They look to get on, and well won. David Coloco. How good has David Coloco been? was here the last few seasons, played in that loss down in Miami in the round of 16 in the NPSL last year. Silva plays it across. Brian James, the 25-year-old midfielder, drafted by Toronto FC in the MLS Super Draft, was Brian. That's a great ball over the top. And Maris looks to play it in. Lamine just a little outside of the foot, whacks it out. Miami's still on it, trying to get inside the area. Long shot, tipped out. And a bounce goes out of bounds for the first goal kick here for Jordan Bell. Waleed Biru, the backup, along with Bryce Billington. You may know Bryce was with the NASL Atlanta Silverbacks behind Stuart Sues and C.J. Cochran. And Waleed, a legendary two-year run there at Little Rock with the Rangers, actually played against Miami in the round of eight in a 3-0 loss, but don't blame Waleed. So I was talking to Carter Krishnai earlier, said that Waleed officially made 14 saves in that match a year ago. Tim Howard-like against Belgium. Here's Lamine, plays it back. Good pace, though, defensively. Trying to win that ball, but Chow not able to get on. Counter-attack, here comes Molly. Karpachugin plays it through. Keeper out. And pace does enough just to knock it out. Crowd wanting a foul on this right side. A corner kick in the end. That speed, the pace of Atlanta, defending 0-60 in about a second flat. Bartman will come over and take this corner kick. See if Alex Frank makes that near post run. He's got a little stack going there with Molly. Prince Sadie in the box as well. Five peach jerseys. Manu Moreno comes on that left side. Just because he's short in stature, Manu can get up. Nazim, the right foot, low line drive. And Iang not able to get under it. O2 with the right foot keeps it in. Sadie with the left foot. A chance in front. And Atlanta SC's on the board first. Molly Carpa Jr. just knocked down moments ago. And he's able to put it in as Atlanta SC rising to the occasion early on here. So in minute number 11, number 11 scores. And it's the first lead in the history of Atlanta SC in NISA play. Oh, that's a good, clever move. And Lamine comes over, well won. And it looks like Kyle Johnson's going to say we're going to the spot as the studs were up. Atlanta FC not happy about this, but Miami FC with a chance to level. It was a good first move. I believe that was Maris in the area. Past the first defender, Lamine came over to help, definitely got ball, but they did change that rule about 3 or 4 years ago. If you get ball, that doesn't necessarily mean it's not a foul. And Kyle Johnston brings Miami FC to the spot. So it's Dylan Maris now against Jordan Bell. So the captain of Miami FC looking to equalize. And he does. Jordan Bell went left. And cool, calm, and collected, Dylan Maris now one goal away from tying Jaime Chavez, a former Atlanta Silverback, with the most goals in franchise history. A And you could hear all the way across the pitch the Atlanta bench saying, we keep playing. A team that fought adversity last Sunday came back twice for that equalizer. Atlanta certainly will not put their heads down here. 0-2 now. Credit Miami, though. Some good work right after they were down to come back the way they did. Silva, as Atlanta retreats. Long ball on this right side. And that's a great turn and a foul one in the end. Prince AD so valuable, coming back on that flank when needed. He's a forward that almost can play as a wingback. Here's Bell. Long line jive, 60 yards down, looking for some of that speed. And I think another corner kick in the end. Yes, it is.
All right, sports fans, we're going to have a halftime dance contest. Please look for Patricia to sign up. We also have the concession stand open. Proceeds will benefit our partnership with Georgia Rush Soccer Club.
Jeffrey O'Toole will take his left foot now on the far side. You saw Nazim on this near side. We'll have another outswinging corner from Jeffrey. Bartman on the edge of the 18. Ramsey Toure Idrisu, the 6'5" presence in there. And that's played out by Gonzalez, the forward who came all the way back. Here's Moreno, played in Spain. Manu, as professional as they come, as hardworking as they come as well. Here's Ramsey Toure. Coloco now. Both teams sort of retreating to midfield defending. Not really much of a high press.
Don't forget, Atlanta Soccer Club fans, the concession stand is still open. Proceeds benefiting Georgia Soccer Club.
Coloco a bit. Well, I was going to say, long as pace came out, defended away, and now at midfield. Harrison Heath now trying to attack down this right side on Moreno. Good job shielding, keeping possession, and playing to the feet of Miguel Gonzalez. Gonzalez with a good switch. Lamine read it well. Alex Frank playing it back. Here's Bartman. Hasn't made his presence felt as of yet, but Nazim, very technical, very clinical. You don't want to give him a space at all. He will make you pay. Has that team leading two goals so far. And a giveaway. Atlanta looks to come on. They cannot. 50-50 ball won by Atlanta SC. Here's Bartman. Plays to feed on this left side. The Prince. Good low ball in front. Eong not able to get on, but that's what they're working on with Sadie. 1-1 here in Alpharetta, Georgia. Molly Karpa in minute number 11. Dylan Maris from the spot in the 13th. Maris on the ball, retreats, plays it back. Brian James now. Played at Penn State with the Nittany Lions. They've got a big football one tonight in Iowa. Looking great are the Nittany so far this season. Brian with 57 appearances with Toronto FC 2. A couple of goals as well. Kyle Johnston playing peacemaker there between Frank and Granito. Remember Tomas with FC Edmonton in his NASL days about 5 or so years ago. Very experienced quality midfielder is Granito from El Salvador. Here's Alex Frank. Again, working that left side with the Prince. Oh! Coloco to Bartman. Well played one time. Lamine looking to go in that space. Just a bit much looking for Molly. Good idea. Maybe play that one on the ground through instead of the air. Here comes Harrison Heath now. And Manu Moreno. That's got to be a dangerous play. Not called on Heath. And Miami looking to press forward. Chow now. And a save by Jordan Bell. The captain coming through. Oh, and trouble played across and just wide. Atlanta SC dodging a bullet on that exchange. Upset, though, that a dangerous play not called is. I believe that was Heath playing with it on the ground with Manu trying to get on it.
Play tough.
Minute number 20 here, 1-1. 0-2 at midfield. A little more pressure being shown by the visitors. Here's Jeffrey, very well done as he weaves his way around James. Sadie trying to be tracked down. Prince. That's a good job in the end. Just knocking it away from Sadie is all you really want to do in that 1v1 situation. Just too dangerous. That's a tricky hop. Unlucky.
Don't forget, Atlanta Soccer Club fans, register for the halftime dance off. Winner will receive a home jersey of Atlanta Soccer Club with your name on the back and number of your choice.
Good stuff here. Murph, a trainer, as well as the PA announcer today. Good stuff from Murph. You want to be trained at A+, check out Murph, as good as they come. Here's Jordan Bell. Bell with another 60-yard bullet down the field. Molly running, not able to get on. The very talented Lloyd Sam, 119 appearances with Charlton Athletic, played 3 years with Leeds as well, wanting the offsides, not getting it. Ball stays in. Heath looks to serve it. 0-2 comes back well. Here's Alex Frank. Again, Atlanta looking to counter. That ball played right at Sam's feet. You may remember Lloyd Sam here in the States with the Red Bulls. Glorious career in New York. 106 appearances, 20 goals. Had a stay with DC United as well. Very decorated is Lloyd Sam. Edge of the area, played through to Harrison Heath. And Manu constantly working hard. Ball still stays in that corner. And a set piece upcoming in that corner here in minute number 22. The visitors will bring in some of their big guns in the back. Silva comes up, the 6'2", 200-pounder. And Atlanta will send Prince out if they can get a counter here with Sadie's speed. Othello Ba better be careful. A couple of Liberians doing battle there. Outside the area. And they'll sandwich Sadie. Here's the set piece, swung out. Jordan Bell barking orders, getting his defense out. And tripping over the ball, trying to stay in possession, cannot. And wanting the foul and finally getting it. As 0-2 was given the business on that far side. Here's Manu now as he plays back. Again, Miami defending almost near midfield. They're giving away that final third here. They'll let Atlanta play as Alex Frank goes. What a brilliant ball all the way to Lamine. Wanting the foul, nothing doing. You see Lamine coming all the way from the back overlapping. Speed, speed, and more speed for Atlanta. helping coach Roberto Neves, Joao Garcia, very experienced, leads some of the tactics. Cristiani Lessa, Abdul Bangura, former silverback, played with the Sierra Leone national team, Din Abdul, former captain here, and the technical director, Karim Deser. Karim, very experienced, works out in Dalton with some inner city kids, does some phenomenal work. And coach Cristiana Lessa, the Brazilian, the first professional female coach here to work in the States with men. Kudos to her. Very well respected is Cristiani. 0-2 as he looks to play long. Carpa, who scored the goal, just a bit much as Molly puts his hands out saying, I'm fast. I'm not that fast. And Atlanta will retreat as well. They give that final third to Silva. Interesting ramifications here tonight. If Atlanta can get a win, they would just need a draw in the finale and stump down to advance to the Eastern Championship against Miami, as we would have a three-peat here, or I should say three matchups. If Atlanta loses or gets a draw tonight, they'll need a victory in Charlotte. That's a good long ball played forward. Here comes Gonzalez, the sniper. He plays it across, tries to facilitate. And Moreno again just making himself big. That's a great ball over the top. Wanting the handball on Coloco, nothing happening in a goal kick.
Hello, sports fans, for Aiden Kushner and Esteban Hurtado, please report to your parents. Dance contest in 15 minutes, folks.
Come on down here to
sign up with Patricia.
The sports complex, the Georgia Rush Sports Complex. 15 minutes of dance contest. Show your moves if you're not too far away. Alex Frank wanting a call, not getting it, and a throw-in for the orange and blue.
Dance contest winner gets a Atlanta Soccer Club home jersey with the favorite player's name and number of your choice.
Oh, that's a good hold-up of the ball, played forward. Developing play here, Miguel Gonzalez, but Atlanta using that quickness and slowing down any sort of a counter. Heath plays it. Gonzalez coming back for it. Sam. Atlanta just trying to close down any channels. Lloyd Sam venturing forward. Double team. Frank comes away with it. 0-2 now. As we welcome in the... Well, I'll still call you the voice of Miami FC because that's what you are. Kartik Krishnayer, welcome, my friend.
Thank you, Justin. Great to be with you. Great atmosphere tonight here, and nice chilly for us from Florida, fall day.
Perfect day. Little bit of wind. I'd say it's in the 70s now as the sun starts going down. We've had so much heat here this summer that it's so pleasant to get a day like this.
Had a lot of rain also this summer, right?
No, not us. No.
Not you guys, huh?
No, not a lot of rain. We save that for you.
Yeah.
Now, talk about you. You got off of the broadcast. You're doing a lot of stuff outside of the broadcast on camera, but talk about what your job now is with Miami FC, as that ball gets played in flags up, however.
Yeah, so the communications department at Miami FC was revamped a little bit after the end of the NPSL season. And those of you familiar with me calling the games in NPSL and assisting with the communication staff, we now have Matthias Wadner, who's actually here with me, right with us in this booth, actually, and myself doing the communications for the club. And we continue to produce video content during the week, which I narrate or host. But we have Lee Iffins and Matt Bunch from Magic City Soccer now calling the games for us in Nisa. And it's been fun, the NISA experiment so far. I should call it an experiment, the NISA experience so far.
Sure, sure. And Matt Lee did a great job. Enjoyed immensely listening to them on Sunday. Phenomenal job. Called it like it was. Gave us credit when we deserved it. Gave you guys credit when you deserved it. Very well done by those guys.
Yeah, they're pros, and they're getting accustomed to this league. And the thing that we're finding is the competition level in this league is really good.
Yes.
It's much better than perhaps anticipated. Before the season began, we weren't sure what to expect in this fall season and this NISA showcase. Competition level's been good.
As Lamine intercepted, though, had a good attack down this right side. But you're exactly right. I don't know if you guys expected us to be what we were. We saw Stumptown, who is a very professional side, came in with a high-quality coach, took care of business. So every team really holding their own so far here in the beginning of NISA.
Yeah, I think the expectation was Stumptown would be pretty good because Mark Steffens is their coach.
Sure.
And he's won a lot in USL.
Legendary,
yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, and I watched him in Pittsburgh. I watched him in Charlotte with the Eagles before that. So we knew to expect a strong side from him and that he has scouting contacts and he would get good players. But Atlanta has been a really pleasant surprise. Fode's put together a nice roster of players. Players I think he knows from the area, but very, very good. And the teams on the West Coast have been better than we expected. I mean, the thought was Oakland was going to be really good. And L.A. Force, because they have an academy feeding them, would be pretty good. Well, it turns out 1904 and Cal United have been better than both those teams so far.
And a bad giveaway here is Miami with some numbers. As that shot goes wide in Atlanta, wow. I'll tell you, you maybe take a dive there and quite possibly you get a call. Ugly play there in the back here in minute number 31. Kartik Krishnayer of Miami FC with us. I'm Justin Hanover. Appreciate you hanging out. 1-1 so far as the score. Molly Carpa Jr. in minute number 11. Then Dylan Maris from the spot. Talk about Dylan. One goal away from Jaime Chavez's all-time record here with Miami FC. What a great player he's been with you guys.
Yeah, Dylan has been a phenomenal player for this club since he came in 2017. Was really good for Indy the previous 3 years.
Yeah.
And actually, I think most of our listeners, viewers know that I worked for Fort Lauderdale prior to working for Miami FC. We got one win over Indy in the period of time when both teams were in the same league, Fort Lauderdale. It was because Dylan was suspended for that match. So he made that much of a difference with Indy 11. Comes to Miami in 2017 and is a really influential box-to-box midfielder at that point in Alessandro Nesta's team. Turned the page to 2018. In Paul Daglish's side, he pushes forward more, begins getting goals. And then this season has already scored almost
four,
double.
Right?
Four in NISA and several in NPSL. So he's approaching double digits on the calendar year. Now with 27 goals, as you mentioned, in club history, approaching Jaime Chavez's record.
Oh, that's a giveaway. Heavy first touch. And now Lloyd Sam, the professional in the back.
The thing about Dylan that's so unique in lower division soccer in the United States is his technical ability. His touch is really good. His vision is fantastic. And he plays incredible through balls when he's in a deep position.
Alex Frank takes a crack, doesn't get the hop. That goes wide. Yeah, I remember Dylan when he came up with Indy 11. He was that young superstar that was ready to burst through. I believe he had a couple of injuries during that tenure, but you saw his worth. I mean, you saw how talented he was.
Yeah, and combined well with some of the guys on that team. Don Smart.
Yeah. Oh, they had one season. Yeah. I believe they went to the final.
Yeah, they won the fall or the spring. I can't remember.
Yeah,
they won one of the halves.
Yeah.
And got to the final and were unlucky against the Cosmos in the final.
Well, it seems like everybody is.
Right.
You talk about the gold standard, the model franchises. You guys, obviously. The Cosmos, certainly. Some of the other teams coming into NISA. You know, Chattanooga.
Yeah.
Detroit. I mean, we've got some fan bases, some franchises, some clubs that really looking forward to. I want to hear your thoughts on that.
Yeah, Justin, it is so exciting to bring Chattanooga and Detroit in. Michigan coming in as well. I don't want to sell the Stars short, but Chattanooga and Detroit are the gold standard in independent soccer in this country. They're the two model clubs. They're the two clubs everybody looks to. They're the two clubs that have developed national followings. When Chattanooga played us in the NPSL playoffs this year, and it was a Tuesday night, 2 days' notice, we had Chattanooga fans wearing Chattanooga shirts from South Florida. It wasn't just the traveling fans.
Okay.
that showed up. And Detroit, we know, is the same way. So that is an absolute boost to NISA. People are judging NISA and NISA attendances and NISA clubs without including those two. They're making a big mistake because I'm not trying to give league propaganda necessarily, but I will say those two clubs will give any club in USL a run for their money in the way they're run from a business standpoint. And it's just going to be incredible to have those two clubs in this league.
No doubt about a business standpoint and an on-the-field standpoint. I mean, if you're playing any of those clubs in an Open Cup match, a Detroit or a Chattanooga, they're going to hang with anybody. I mean, you guys saw that. Chattanooga, you guys outclassed them in the end in that 2-0 win. But a very talented side, very well coached, just a model organization.
And we know nobody wants to face Detroit in Open Cup every year because they know their fans will travel. And we saw what Cincinnati did, the gamesmanship of limiting tickets when they drew Detroit because Cincinnati is talked about as one of the great teams in MLS. They would have been outdrawn in their own building potentially by Detroit fans.
And what a run they had, FC Cincinnati. Believe they were in the semis and against the Red Bulls, and they were up 2 goals late.
And they blew it.
Wow, and they blew it, yeah. Without being blunt, they blew it. Here's Heath on this far side. Match has really settled down a little bit. Little fireworks early on. I think everybody's just sort of calmed down.
Yeah, a lot of good attacking play in the first 11 or 12 minutes. The pace of Atlanta we saw last week can get behind, particularly kind of a makeshift back line.
Look at Iyang. Just a beast. You know him from a couple of times. Bartman.
Iyang, this is the fourth time Miami FC is playing against him this season, has been impressive in every match. Played for Central Florida in the NPSL in the spring and could do everything for that team other than finish chances, but really, really good player. But the match has now settled into a pattern, which is good to see. We saw some stretched end-to-end actions, a nice through ball from Harrison Heath that almost sprung a chance.
He's playing well.
Yeah.
He played well on Sunday. He's playing well here. You know, Harrison, high expectations for him. Yeah. I think he wanted ultimately to play MLS. His dad obviously coaching there, and it just didn't sort of happen as of yet. But he's still a young kid at 23, still has plenty of life left in him.
Yeah, still has a chance to work his way back in. And he had some moments with Minnesota and with Atlanta.
He did, played Open Cup, had a few minutes with Atlanta against you guys. It was you guys
in the
when
Open Cup.
Poku scored that amazing goal at the end. Were you on that call? I know Bruce was.
Bruce was on that call. Yeah, I was Bruce not Silverman, there, but Harrison actually gave the ball away.
He did. I didn't want to say that. I'll let you be the bad guy. But
he'll own it. I mean, mid-step. But Harrison's been great influence in the dressing room also. This sounds very cliche-ish, Justin, but he's the son of a coach.
Oh, yeah.
He's the son of a really good coach, and he's the son of a great player. And he brings those attributes to training every day.
And he just got beat there. Look at Jeffrey Otu, another former Atlanta player, Atlanta United. Alex Frank will settle things down. David Coloco, very good on this right side. Playing in the back, Coloco played as the sixth in NPSL play last season, able to really be versatile and go anywhere.
Also have to mention about Harrison, a player that I thought was not given a shot in Orlando after his dad was let go as the coach. He played very well under Jason Kreis for the first few matches, but him being Inchi's son, Adrian Heath's son, it seemed like they'd made a decision to let him go.
Right.
I think he could have helped that team a lot.
And Orlando certainly,
you
talk about a feast or famine team. They'll win 5 in a row, then they'll lose 8 in a row. It's just they're just not able to get that rhythm to be consistent. A lot of talent there, but wow.
Yeah, this is the first year where they had one win, one loss, one draw type of thing. Previous four seasons they've been in MLS. It's usually been 5-6 games unbeaten and then an 11-game winless streak.
Very inconsistent.
Very bad.
They run out of real estate here. It'll be a throw-in for Lamine as we reach minute number 38. Still 1-1. Here comes Iyang showing that speed on Silva. A lot of contact and just a goal kick in the end.
As we sort this out, I have to say, Justin, I'm really impressed by the level of club that Fode has assembled here, and that tells you how much talent there is in the Atlanta area, and something always thought the Silverbacks could take advantage of in the past, and now Atlanta SC.
Well, there's nobody better than Fode Dalla reaching out with his contacts, bringing guys in from Liberia, Sierra Leone, local kids from here. He's done it for 4 or 5 years now, just blending talented guys together with a positive attitude, and you see the fruits of it right now with this professional club.
Yeah, and it is a step up to move up from NPSL to this level, but this club, despite the poor first half against Stumptown, since then has been pretty good.
Well, you know, yes, it was poor, but it was also they had 5 days of training.
Right, yeah.
There's not a club on this planet that can be successful when training together for 5 days.
Right.
You saw in that last match, we had about 3 weeks, which is still not enough, but you saw what Roberto Neves was able to do, at least get the guys together, and they look so much better, light years better. Miami FC playing all the way back, intent to just reset with Silva. Makeshift back line you guys have today, isn't it?
Yeah, we don't have Brenton Griffiths or Lance Roseboom, who sometimes slot into the back line. If he's not playing on the back line, he plays right in front of the back four. So that disrupts a little bit of the continuity there. But Matias Silva, a player we just signed, former Orlando City player, former San Jose Earthquake, a real strong addition.
What's with you guys in San Jose Earthquakes? There's got to be a pipeline there. There's a certain
and Seattle,
keeper.
Too.
Well, with San Jose, there's a certain keeper that you used to have that's there now that's pretty good.
Yeah, Daniel Vega had a really good season after a little bit of shaky start, club legend. And actually, he's the all-time appearance leader for Miami FC with 88 appearances. If Ariel Martinez comes on the pitch here in the second half, he will equal that record of 88 appearances. But an absolute club legend and a great professional to work with.
Well, he'll... Pardon me, I think he breaks it tonight. Does he not?
He
as the flag goes up. I think he evened it last match.
He evens it this week. I
think if Ariel comes in,
you're right.
He gets the all-time record.
Right, you're correct.
Yeah, with 89. Yeah, what a legend he is. I mean, you talk about a guy with all the caps in Cuba, goals in Cuba, just Ariel's. What a great presence to have.
And Daniel Vega was such an incredible presence in the dressing room for Miami FC and between the pipes, obviously. But just a great guy, and it's a wonderful thing for our club to see him be so successful in MLS this season.
It seems like he gave up that one oops goal a couple of months ago. I'm sure you've seen it. Everybody's seen it. And since that point, his game raised up and – there was no putting his head down after that.
Yeah, that was obviously... We've seen a couple of those goals in MLS this season from various keepers with their feet not being as strong.
Minute number 41 here in Alpharetta, Georgia. At the Georgia Rush Sports Complex. Appreciate you joining us. He's Kartik Krishnayer with Miami FC. I'm Justin Hanover. Level at one apiece. You guys have settled in well. I think early on we were making some runs, and we looked to be the better side 10, 12 minutes in. You guys have done a nice job to sort of dumb it down, I think.
I think part of it is the pace of Atlanta caught us off guard last week. And you remember the fantastic chance in the 12th minute.
Oh, sure.
That
by William.
That Bryant saved, who was in playing keeper for us last week. And similar thing happened this week. And obviously led to a goal off that corner. But since then, settle into the match. And this tends to happen, Justin, in Miami FC games. It's also a fitness issue. We had a full preseason starting in January. We've been training since then. That we tend to, if there are let-offs in matches, they tend to be early in matches.
5 minutes. Don't forget to sign up for your dance contest.
You're going
to
get in the dance contest?
Come up to the booth.
I'm tempted by it. Didn't know about it until
moves?
Just now, but maybe. Yeah.
I am not.
Sign up at the booth.
In all likelihood, I'll pass, too. I'm a bit of a coward with that stuff.
Homer, raise your hand. Homer, Atlanta Soccer Club, Georgia.
As we approach, well, I was going to say as we approach ahead of time. Not yet. Approaching minute number 43, still 1-1. Little push there from Harrison. Good ball over the top. Lamine looking to defend. Here comes Ba. Talk about Othello Ba. Now, he's a forward, but he's playing in the back now. Very versatile as a 24-year-old.
Yeah, what happened was Baggio, who had played for us at NASL and was a fantastic player, I mean, one of Bruce Silverman, our mutual friend Bruce Silverman's favorite Miami FC players, went down with an injury 6 minutes into the season. And then we had John Niskins, who is a left-footer but a center back. He got injured as well. Othello Ba learned this position on the fly in NPSL because we didn't have another left-sided kind of wide player even that could play left back, and he's now made that position his own.
Not easy to do. I mean, all the kids out there, that should teach you a lesson. Be versatile. You know, when a lot of these young kids are saying, oh, I'm a forward. You know what? Learn to play in the back. It may open up a little bit of space and give you some more time to play.
I think the thing that shocked us about Ba is that his defensive instincts were there from the first match right. He had to play there, which you don't get with forwards often. You sometimes don't get with guys who are even left backs because they want to bomb forward in the modern game. No position has changed more than the fullback position in football and soccer over the course of the last few years.
Very well played there. Bartman and Frank really developing a partnership. O2 trying to get through, could not. Good first 45 from Jeffrey. He commits that foul. As he gives Maris a nice knock on this near side. Kyle Johnston, the center official, by the way, a very good goalkeeper. I have watched Kyle play. Very quality goalkeeper.
And how tall is he?
Not tall, but
he's fairly tall, isn't he?
No, he's not tall. He may be 5'9", 5'10".
Yeah.
Here comes Karp, who scored that first goal. Little one-on-one situation. He plays back to Iyang. William looking to put it on that left foot. Nothing doing. Bartman with a clever run. Here's Nazim. Karpa flips it up. Oh, that's a good touch, but offsides in the end is Molly.
Justin, if you remember in the NASL days, we had some great small goalkeepers like Akira Fitzgerald in Carolina.
Yeah,
and Diego Restrepo, who played before Lauderdale and with Tampa Bay.
Well, how big was Jimmy with the Cosmos? He was fairly tall, I guess. Six one.
Here in Atlanta also, obviously, was
Jimmy's
very good.
From here, absolutely.
And I should mention Tyler Ruthven announced his retirement.
Congratulations to Tyler. Great 10-year career or whatever. Played here, played with you guys as we get into added time officially. Yeah, Tyler was with the Silverbacks for a year or two. Looking for Prince now. Sam just gets enough on, I believe.
Ooh.
And you see just the electric speed. Prince AD, not many guys are going to outrun him.
Yeah, CD is one of the quickest, paciest players I've seen in lower division soccer in the last few years.
I don't know how you can be any faster than Prince.
Yeah.
Once he starts refining that game, I think he's going to start moving up levels in his future.
Yeah, and I would say this, make the same commentary about Iyang, who, as I mentioned, we've seen four times this season at Miami FC.
Yeah.
We played against him four times. He has a fantastic game. He has an all-around game. Once he gets that finishing touch, he's going to be unplayable, in my opinion.
Yeah.
He's going to be really good.
And also Nazim Bartman, who's leading the way with two goals. South African was a fourth-round MLS draft pick with Vancouver. Just phenomenal technical. Well, they do blow the whistle. So a 1-1 first half. Atlanta looked good. Miami rallied back. Molly Carper in the 11th. Dylan Maris in the 13th.
Yeah, really exciting, frenzied start from both sides. Stretched match, Justin, but then settled after about the 20th minute. It's been good football.
And it'll be fun because Atlanta needs 3 points tonight in order to only play for that draw in 2 weeks in Stumptown. So we're 1-1 at the break. He's Gardner Krishnaya. I'm Justin Hanover. We will be back in about 10, 12 or so minutes here on the Atlanta SC Network.
Dance contestants start making it up to the field. All you dance contestants start making it down to the field.
Yeah, sounded good.
Yeah, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Here's the goal.
Molly Carper Jr. just knocked down moments ago.
All dancers, please meet us on the field right now. All dancers, gonna get
a couple
just
minutes to
short stature, man, who can get up.
And we're going to have judges tap the
end.
Good play back
not
in.
Not able to get under it. O2 with the right foot keeps it in. Sadie with
way
the left
to keep
foot.
With it.
A chance in front. And Atlanta SC's on the board first. Molly Copper Jr. just knocked down moments ago. And he's able to put it
on
in.
On dancers, deepened. Can you pick all the dancers down to the right?
Pass the first defender. The spot as the studs were up in it needs to play.
Move.
Oh, that's a good, clever move. And Lamine comes over well won. And it looks like Kyle Johnson's going to say we're going to the spot. As the studs were up, Atlanta FC
not happy
about this.
But I mean, look. Look.
I don't understand, but...
Oh, that's a good, clever move.
Okay, folks. So Steph,
the ball is in front of the guy. He got the ball.
And it looks like Kyle Johnson's going to say we're going to the spot. It was about a...
All right, folks, Stephanie's going to explain the rules of the contest.
All right, good evening, everyone. We're going to do a dance-off. It's 1 minute each. The first two rounds, everyone is dancing, so give us what you got. We'll pick three finalists, and then the audience, you need to pay attention because the audience is going to pick the winner. Okay, and the third round. So enjoy the music. Dancers, here you go.
All right, good evening, everyone. We're going to take a dance off. Go for it. I'm going to go down there. 1 minute each. The first two rounds, everyone is there. This is what you got. We'll pick three finalists, and then the audience needs to pay attention because the audience is going to
play. Shit, I need
okay.
Powers.
And the third round.
Oh, you do it. Emory wants to score in my car. Oh, no, we don't. We're not able to.
Okay, we're going to begin in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Coach Stephanie, are we ready? Okay.
Now watch me whip, now watch me nay nay.
Okay.
Now watch me whip, watch me nay nay.
Why me do it?
Now watch me whip,
kill it.
Watch me nay nay.
Okay.
Now watch me whip, watch me nay nay.
Can you do it?
Now watch me, ooh, watch me, watch me, ooh, watch me, watch me, ooh, watch me, watch me, ooh.
Okay.
Ooh,
okay.
Ooh, watch me, watch me, ooh, watch me, watch me.
10, 9, 8, 7. 6, 5. Stanky leg, folks. Where the stanky leg at? Stanky leg, shake it. Shake it, fellas. 4, 3, 2. All right, first round. Who stand? All right, second round. We have 1 more minute. Here we go. Old Town Road.
I got the horses in the back, horse stock is attached, head is matted black, got the bushes black to match, riding on a horse, you can whip your horse, I've been in the valley, you've been up off that porch, now can't nobody feel me nothing, you can't feel me nothing, can't nobody feel me nothing. On the track, lean all in my buddy, cheated on my buddy, you can go with us, my life is a movie, boy.
Alright.
Okay, okay, don't worry about it.
Oh, that looks better, actually. That looks better. But can you do the rewrite the right? Can you do that writing again? Only if people have liked it. See it.
Can't find it.
Oh,
did you get Nene yet?
You already know who it is. Silent talk.
Final round. Final round. Steph. Last one. Okay, here we go.
You already know who it is. Solid talk. Don't it do it for me? Now watch me whip. Kill it. Now watch me, nene. Okay. Now watch me whip. Watch me, nene. Why me do it? Now watch me whip. Kill it. Watch me, nene. Okay. Now watch me whip. Well, watch me, nene. Yeah, you do it. Now I need. Ooh, watch me, watch me. Ooh, watch me, watch me. Ooh, watch me, watch me. Ooh, okay.
Do the stanky leg.
We're going to have the crowd. We need your assistance here. All right, who's voting for first? First contestant. Raise your hand, princess in the pink shirt. Ladies first, raise your hand. Okay. All right, that's a great response. Let's go. Next contestant, let's hear you, crowd. And how about our six-year-old, the new six-year-old? It looks like we might need a cheer-off. It sounds like a tie between the last and the first and third. Can we have a cheer-off? Ladies first. Let's go. Raise your hand, princess. Okay, let's cheer for this one. All right, contestant number two. Okay, number two is the winner. No. Apologize for my judge, Miss Stephanie. Both of them are winners. We have a tie. Both of them winners. We have a tie.
came to get down. So get down your seat and jump around. Jump around. Jump around.
Is that our plan?
And welcome back. Second half action, 1-1. Miami FC and Atlanta SC. It was Molly Carpa Jr. in the 11th minute. Dylan Maris leveled with a penalty in the 13th. We're going to, due to technical difficulties, stay off the audio until minute number 65. So the video will be here. We'll be back on the audio on minute number 65 here at 1-1 at the Georgia Rush Sports Complex.
Send it.
Oh, that is ridiculous. He didn't even see the guy who is facing the other direction.
Because he kind of had a high kick, but the guy ran into him from the blind side.
He wasn't.
He didn't know that he was going to be there. Yeah, this guy has one of the over the years. This guy has the double.
Nobody ever seen you roll out of the door. Maybe we're biased.
Yeah.
I guess nobody ever does. Oh, do you guys, the beneficiaries?
Go, Keith!
I felt like that in the NPSL though.
Yeah.
We're getting more.
Oh, no. That's not offside. Go.
Yeah, that's why. Should be up here, right here.
No, I saw it.
Yeah.
Don't worry.
I saw it.
I got almost three.
These things grow legs, don't they? You have yours? Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Go.
God like, 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 God like,
Attention Atlanta Soccer Club fans, all players will remain on the field after the game. All parents and children are allowed to go on the field to get autographs from the players.
not a very good view.
Don't forget, the concession stand is still open. Don't forget to get your food and beverages from the concession stand, benefiting Georgia Rush Soccer Club. Also, Atlanta Soccer Club fans, don't forget to stay after the game, hit the field, and take pictures and get your autograph from your favorite Atlanta Soccer Club player. Atlanta Soccer Club fans, let's get it up for your team. Let's get it up, Atlanta Soccer. Deacon, get it up for the Atlanta Soccer Club. Make some noise.
This thing's not staying on. This thing keeps turning off.
It's not telling you?
Nah, it's not charging.
Let's just go on and make it last.
Yeah.
Let's make it Hanukkah heavy oil.
That's it.
No. So you're going to pull it or go for it?
No, I think we just got to keep it going here for the... See, this thing just, like, it just, like, keeps turning off. Thank you.
adjusting your minute 65 if you want to.
Yeah, I don't think it refreshed as much as you were thinking.
Oh. You might just have to hop on the last 5 minutes.
Oh, go!
Let's go, Atlanta. Let's make some noise for the home team. Let's go, Atlanta. Let's go, Atlanta fans. Make some noise. ATL.
Yeah, no, he's charging.
No, but it keeps turning off. The blue lights turn off.
Yeah, it's fine.
No, it's... See, look, the blue lights turn off again.
Yeah, when you turn on your spot, it's still charging.
I don't think so.
I'll see what's wrong.
Yeah, because it's still going. It's not charging up. Oh, it is 16, all right.
Don't worry.
It's all right.
It goes off.
It does that.
Don't forget, concession stands are still open. Ricardo George in for Muhammad Lamine for the Atlanta Soccer Club. Goal by the Blitz. Let's go, Atlanta. Jump around. Welcome to Atlanta. Welcome to Atlanta. Yes, sir.
Oh, shit.
Can I ask a letter so I can come down by number 10, Prince? Prince? Soccer club substitution, Carlisle coming in from Molly.
Maddie!
Another solid defensive stance by the Atlanta Soccer Club. Get together midfield at the end of the game to go take pictures and get the autograph of your favorite ATL soccer club player.
So I've got 20%.
Go, go, go.
And appreciate you hanging with us here. Some technical difficulties. Now back right around minute number 80, tied at 2 apiece. Chow with his third goal in the last 2 matches against Atlanta in minute number 58 from Dylan Maris. And then the absolute laser golazo from Prince Eddie in minute number 69 off that ball from Ricardo George. And we are level at 2 apiece here in minute number 81. Atlanta pressing, looking to get all 3 points so they could just manage a draw and win the Eastern Conference with that match in Stumptown. Miami made a substitution. Ariel Martinez came in about 10 minutes ago, 15 minutes ago. Now the all-time leader in appearances, surpassing Daniel Vega in Miami FC history. Now with 89. Jeffrey Otu, very solid night, serving that ball up to the Prince, who now moved to that right side, moved away from Lloyd Sam, tussling with Othello Ba, and that goal an absolute thing of beauty in the 69th. So Atlanta pushing, looking for a third. Appreciate you joining us here. I'm Justin Hanover. We're at the Georgia Rush Sports Complex. Ball played over on the throw to Alex. And here's Carlisle, who subbed in for Molly. And Nazim looking for the volley. That gets blocked. Nazim Bartman with 2 goals leading the way for Atlanta here in this NISA schedule. Atlanta scored the first goal off of a Bartman corner. Sadie had a shot that was saved by Pace, and then the rebound put in by Karpa. Here is Nazim. Plays it long. Oh, there's a lot of contact. Incidental in the end, I guess. Jeffrey Otu hitting that out of bounds. Otu looking very good today here through minute number 83. Very active. Picked up a yellow earlier. Very active is Jeffrey. Miami now on the near side. Here's Lloyd Sam as Iyang tracks down that angle. Both sides have shown glimpses tonight. And there's Maris. Converted that penalty in minute number 13 to level the match at a goal apiece. Clever stuff from Martinez. Now Lloyd Sam. Talk about experience. Martinez and Sam. About as experienced as you can get. Tried to play it through. Coloco intercepts. Oh, heavy touch from Ricardo. Well intercepted there by Ramsey Torrey. Play simple. Iyang receives. Gets around Lloyd Sam. Here comes the big fella. Looks for Carlisle. Not able to thread that needle. Gets it on that strong left foot. Here comes William Iyang. Serves it across. Prince, can he get on? Oh, and Sadie just miskicked that one. Good stuff from William Iyang on this near side. Miami FC will have a substitution. Miguel Gonzalez will leave the match, the talented forward. Sean Chin, who pretty much can play everywhere. Literally. The Sharif Suma of Miami FC. So Chin will come on, probably look to see out the point here. Again, a draw is very favorable in the end for Miami FC. Coach El Gleish may not love the way his team's playing, but a draw will get them the home field in the Eastern Conference Championship. Due to beating Stumptown twice, remember Atlanta lost to Stumptown 3-1 in that first meeting. And one match remaining will be in Charlotte in a couple of Fridays from today. So So now in minute number 86, we'll have a couple added. Good ball over. Oh. Lloyd Sam just did enough. And a man down here on that far side for the orange and blue. Appreciate you hanging here with us on the Atlanta SC Network. 2-2, Miami FC and Atlanta SC, presented by A-Plus Sports in Alpharetta. Check it out, the best training facility around, A-Plus Sports in Alpharetta.
All fans, please make sure to wait at midfield after the game before getting your autograph and pictures with your SC soccer players. Please do not rush the field. You will be escorted out.
Appreciate Vitella as well in Alpharetta. Check it out. Google it. Vitella, V-I-T-A-L-A, C-B-D. Vitella, C-B-D. Marco Franco, the former Indy 11 player, just like Dylan Maris. He'll check in for Othello Ba. Marco becoming the super sub here for Miami. Good ball forward as they get in the area. And cleared away by Ramsey. Again, if Atlanta does not get 3 points tonight, they will need a win in Stumptown on Friday the 25th. Nothing else would do to get in that Eastern Championship. A win here, though, would allow a draw in that match to advance. So pretty much a draw and a loss here is the same for Atlanta. As Nazim gets called for that foul. Appreciate Marco Zucchi here helping out on the cameras. Good work from Marco, putting his computer skills behind this broadcast. Martinez and Maris on the ball. Bit too far to take a go at goal, one would think. Two-man wall, Carlisle and Zemo. Jeffrey O2 behind, conducting some traffic with Alex Frank. Heels on the 18. And here is Maris. Lofts one up. Not a bad ball. Headed just over frame by Dario Suarez. As we are in minute number 89, three or four I would expect to be added, so within the final 5 minutes of this one, tied at two. Carpa and Sadie for Atlanta. Maris, and who else but Chow, now with 3 goals in these last 2 contests for Miami. And they've put Lloyd Sam at that left back position. Silva to Sam. They try and close down. Let's see if Atlanta can bring a little bit of a press. Carlisle trying to get the angle. Franco plays simple defeat. Here's Chin. Sean played with San Antonio FC. Played with the Switchbacks. Fort Lauderdale Strikers. He's been around for a while, has the 30-year-old. Very experienced, very versatile. Oh, clever stuff here on these one-time balls. Nothing comes to fruition in the end, but a throw-in for Miami FC and another substitution, this time for Atlanta. William Eyang will check out in minute number 90. Well, he won't check out just yet. As Atlanta's trainer, Harold King, will come out. Nazim Bartman looks like he was cramping up a little bit as he runs off. So they'll keep... Well, I would assume they'll keep William on, and, well, no. Nazim will stay on. William Eyang is out. And it looks like Adi will make his first appearance here with Atlanta SC. So Ade is in the back. They bring William Eyang out. Atlanta certainly needs to go forward, try and get a third here. That's not an offensive move, however. Big switch. Takeaway by Carlisle. Here is Ade. Little 1v1 situation. And Bartman gets dispossessed. And here comes Martinez on the counter. Final moments here. Couple of minutes added on. Two extra officially was announced. 2 minutes added. Tied at two. Deuces are wild. And there it is. So history has repeated itself. A 2-2 draw in Miami. 6 days later, a 2-2 draw in Atlanta. Very well played by both sides. Prince Sadie with one of the greatest goals you'll ever see. That leveled it. Atlanta will now need 3 points at Stumptown on Friday the 25th in order to advance to an Eastern Conference championship, which would be played in Miami. Thanks to everybody here. Carter Chris Schneier, Matthias Wudner, thank you to them with Miami FC, Marco Zucchi, Fode Dollar, Murph, everybody here in Atlanta. A phenomenal match at a great facility at Georgia Rush's Sports Complex. Check out social media with Atlanta Soccer Club, ATL Soccer Club. Plenty of good stuff to come in the upcoming weeks. We finish with a 2-2 draw here in Atlanta. Thanks, everybody. I'm Justin Hanover. Have a great night.
Against Miami. Thank you for attending. If you'd like to get the autograph of the Atlanta Soccer Club players, please start assembling at midfield on the hill. For Miss Melinda, wearing all black with the camera around the right shoulder.
I would like to. Do we have juice to do it here?
I've got like, I think like 10, 18, 14%. So I'm going to see if we can get the gimbal.
Prince.
And then,
hey, yeah, let's get Prince. Should we do... Hey, is this better than having Karen?
Yeah, because this is... It'll be clipped into the screen.
Baby, let me... I did it again, so I'm gonna let go. Oh, my... Baby, let me love you down. There's so many ways to love you. Maybe I can break you down. There's so many ways to love ya. Got me like, oh my God, I'm so in love. I found you first.
Where should we do it? You
make me wanna say,
should we go in front over there on the hill?
I fell in love with Shawty.
yours. Take that one and go.
I'm going to do it on here, a couple of interviews with Marco on the stream.
Do you have a gimbal?
Yeah, let's talk to the whole camera. Do you have the clip?
Yeah, no.
The oh, that's just your camera. Yeah. All right. We'll do it the old school way.
Oh, you're doing it that way.
Do you care what side I'm on?
Choose wisely.
Hold on, grab, grab one mic.
Fill my soul, fulfill my heart, cross my heart, and hold to God.
Fill
my soul, fulfill my heart.
Every time I get one step,
I know this is difficult.
Step
a second is paper, it's sort of habitual. Money will give me a heart on a typical. I wanted a physical. $1 million, I count off in intervals. Without it, I'm miserable. Don't want to fall off, so I'm all in my bag. Thinking God like it's biblical. I know it's gonna solve every problem I have. I bought on a principle. Remember the teachers is all on my ass. Now look, all of them pitiful. And all of a sudden, I'm so good at math. Count it up. Count it up, count it up, count it, count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, can't take it when you die, but you can't live without it. Count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, count it up, count it up, count it up, count it, can't take it.
All right, so one more.
Oh no, don't stress, big pills, big pills.
I fell in love
with big wheels and quick.
There
my chicken's running tip drills. Can't sit still. Don't give a f**k if it kills. It mix well. I'm on.
Waiting here on couple of Atlanta SC players. Fode Dalla is going to bring a couple of the fellas here, hopefully Prince and maybe Jordan Bell.
Got mama cutting a 40 abortion. The loneliest orphan. I flip my misfortune and call me a fortune. My role is scorching. Them tickets that hated it slowly endorsing.
Yep, they're signing some autographs for the kids. We'll get Prince AD, Jordan Bell up here momentarily. Actually, you want to talk? Let's talk to the president and general manager while we're at it. Fode Dalla. Another great effort. Another draw against a team that won 16 straight games. Suddenly, they're winless now in their last two.
Yeah, I think one thing is that the team spirit is high. After our first game, we had a very good about 2 weeks, 3 weeks of training. We built characters. We built team chemistry, and the coach. Thanks to the coaching staff, they did a very good job. The boys have come a long way. We come through. We deal with a lot of stuff, but I'm very proud of these guys. They have kept their heads high. They work hard, and it speaks for itself.
And it seems like everybody's doing their job. You've got the midfield play with Alex and Jeffrey look really good tonight. The forwards, Prince and Molly and William, the back line stayed strong together. It's like everybody's beginning to really know their role.
Yeah, exactly. That's why the 3 weeks breaks gave a very good time for the coaching staff to really work together with these guys. And we got quality. We got quality players. They needed some time to really work together to gel. But like you said, I mean, the whole team, the goalkeepers, the leader out there, Jordan have done a tremendous job there. The midfielders anchored by Alex, and their defense with Kuluku and Ramsey. Ramsey brought a very fresh air for us here, you know, center backs. And then our front lines, like the Prince, the William, the Molly, the Nazim, They brought Nazim as a false nine, like a come striker. I think the team is doing very, very well. I think the sky is their limit.
And this complex here, beautiful night. Georgia Rush Sports Complex. It really lived up to the billing. A beautiful hill here. A lot of people came out. What a fun night. What a fun environment.
I mean, when I go with the team, I say it's about building a community. And this is our thing. We want to build a community. And it's right here. This is right in the heart of Milton, Alpharetta, Johns Creek, Cherokee, Kami. It's right in the middle, you know. It's a community vibe we're trying to build over here. And thanks to the fans, you know. I didn't expect this. Well, after changing the time from 7 to 5, still people found their way out there. I'm very proud of the community. Again, we're trying to build a community. That's what we say. Our slogan is one club, one community. So thanks to the community, thanks to the fans for showing up here. There's a great location, right? Great facility. We want to build on this. And thanks to Georgia Rush, technical director they gave us great support over here, and we are, and thanks to all of you guys for the hard work you guys have been doing here. So we're trying to make this turn this into a beautiful complex that we can really play a pros game out here. We're bringing professional game to the community in your backyard.
So that's FD Dollar. Appreciate it. Fode, president, general manager of this club, building something special here, building a culture. Let's see, we're going to get, I think, Prince. We're going to get Jordan. We'll get a couple of guys up here. Thank you, FD.
Thank you very much, guys.
Good stuff. He's the architect of this entire situation. Make sure you come down here at our next match when we do play in the next season eventually. It is a great facility. I mean, it's got 5 pitches all the way around. Georgia Rush plays here. We train here. Unbelievable as we bring in the Prince AD. I don't even know where to begin, so we're just going to begin with that goal. That is an absolute golazo. Just talk about that play.
Yeah, the goal was great, and I saw the pass from my teammate, and I make that run and caught in, and I hit for the last post.
Now, in training, you've been working on that, but more of the cross. It's been more of the cross where everybody wants you to put that. I didn't even know you had that in you. I mean, you just bombed away at it. Did you know once that left your foot, you had that? It felt that sweet.
Yeah, I've been doing that for long. I got a couple of goals like that. So I knew it was in.
So not much of a surprise then for you. You down that left flank, then they moved you to the right flank. Your speed absolutely killing them, creating fits for Paul Dalglish and that Miami team. It's just amazing what speed can do, and you just have that. It's the full package.
Yeah. Like I told you in an interview, I've been doing this all my life, so it's part of me. Yeah.
And the team building. 2 draws against a team that won 16 straight games. How are the boys feeling right now down on pitch level?
We're feeling good. We're feeling excited. And we're looking forward to the next game.
Prince AD, the man of the match. Congratulations, Prince. What a phenomenal goal. Maybe we'll see that on ESPN or whatever coming up. See if we can get Jordan. Jordan Bell hopefully will come up here. Maybe Prince will get him for us. Very mild-mannered, low-key. And here comes the captain, Jordan Bell. Here is the captain. Well done. Another hard-fought draw. You played a team that won 16 straight matches. You've struck a little bit of fear in them in these last 2 matches.
Yeah, I think the boys done absolutely brilliant from the start to the very end. I was at home tonight. I think that was in our favour a little bit. We wanted to take it to them. Whereas last week was a little bit different going down in difficult circumstances. But tonight, I thought the boys were absolutely fantastic from start to finish. Off the ball, that's all we can ask for. Defend as a unit and attack as a unit. And I think we got what we deserved, maybe. I don't know. I don't really know how I feel right now.
A great draw, nonetheless. Yeah. Maybe you deserved a third, maybe not. Talk about the back line. Ramsey Torres has only been here a couple of weeks. Manu's only been here a couple of weeks. You've got Lamine and Ricardo and just everybody else. Really, a real good job. You guys are gelling quickly.
Yeah, I mean, the boys at the back are brilliant. We work a lot in training, myself, the back 4, and then the 2 centre mids together. And we kind of just organisation, that's key. Every time you're checking your shoulder, you're not ball watching. But at this level, you're going to come up against good teams and you need to be on it from the start. So the boys have been brilliant at the back and I can't praise them enough.
Finishing up here with Jordan Bell, amazing save you made on one of those free kicks. Phenomenal. Talk about this sports complex, the crowd that came here tonight, this evening as a whole. It felt real good. It felt like there's a culture building.
Yeah, I mean, we're grateful to be here at Georgia Rush Complex. I mean, we've been training here as well. And it feels good as well. The fans have been brilliant. They're right here, right in front of you, so that they can give you a right good atmosphere. And we're building something special here for the spring. I mean, we want to be one of the top teams in the country, and it starts here against other top teams. But, yeah, we're excited for the spring. I just wanted to thank all the fans as well for coming out in their numbers.
Need your reaction on that Prince goal. That's got to be one of the best goals you've ever seen. Maybe not the best, but that's got to be up there, is it not?
Yeah, I mean, it was a hit and hope. No, I'm joking. It was a brilliant finish. Took a touch inside, and he's got a deadly left foot, and he does it in training every day, so there's no reason why he shouldn't do it in a game, and it was a brilliant finish, so well done.
There's the captain, Jordan Bell. Very well done by you, my friend. 2-2 draw here in Atlanta. Molly Karpa, Prince AD, get Atlanta on the board. Back-to-back draws against Miami. Good stuff being built here. Thanks to Georgia Rush Sports Complex, FD, everybody else involved, Marco Zucchi, A-Plus Sports. A fun night. A lot more to come in the future. Stay with us with Atlanta Soccer Club. Have a great night, everybody.